Hey, what is up everyone, this is Dynamon here, welcome back to some more Pokemon Worldwide 2 Redux. In the last episode, we went through whatever this route was, I don't remember. I don't know, it just says P2 Laboratory here. I think it's... I don't know. It's a route, okay? Let's just keep it at that. And then we arrived here at the P2 Laboratory. We also caught Latios in the last episode. And, now we're going to explore this place with Team Plasma being here. I wonder what they have got up their sleeve here, if anything. Without further ado, let's get right into it. But before we do that, let's see what kind of interesting... Maybe there's some interesting things in this grass here at the P2 Laboratory. We got a Clink. So, we've seen that before, obviously, in the Charred Stone Cave. So, nothing really interesting there. There's a Herdier. Oh, there's a Scrafty here. Interesting. Watchhog. Okay, nothing really that interesting in here, but yeah, what's to be expected. I mean, at this point of the game, I'm not really planning to change my team anyways. Oh, it's just you. Neither Gatsus nor Kouros changed me. I guess I'm the only one who can change myself. Alright. Let's see what we have here. This is definitely a Genesect right here.
Reading now. Life signs are dormant. Vital signs are fluctuating. Increase power to maximum capacity.
Uh-oh.
Yes! Life signs are spiking! We've done it! It's alive!
All levels are normal.
All levels are nominal. The next Genesect project is booting up.
Now to test the machine, let's give it an order.
Frank, what's wrong?
Intruder!
What should we do?
What else does he teach his bug a lesson?
Let's see what his new creation can do.
Genesect, use that Ignoblast!
Team Genesect, turn on the scientists.
Oh man, that thing packs a punch! Come on, let's get out of here!
Oh, it's Kouros. What's all this noise? Oh, it's you, it's been a while. It seems that you've stumbled upon Team Plasma's old Genesect project. It was supposed to be discontinued, but it seems we have some rogues. I see it's just the two of us now, except for this Genesect. I believe you are the first... You were the first being it saw when it came to life. It seems to want to travel with you. Well, you've certainly shown me the bonds you have with Pokemon. I'd be grateful if you can take the Genesect with you on your travels. Though, it's your decision, of course. No matter what you choose to do, I'd like to leave you with this project over, and hate for anyone else to get their hands on them.
Ooh, a douche drive, okay. And a shock drive. He's just gonna give me all the drives, I guess. Alright, fair enough. So do we just get to take it, or do we actually have to catch it?
Well then, please excuse me, I must go and arrange for someone to clean up this mess.
I think we actually have to catch it right here. Alright, let's go ahead and do this. There we go, Genesect. Probably one of my favorite mythicals, if not my favorite mythical that exists. I really like Zeraora as well. I think those two are probably my favorites. Alright, let's go ahead and glare this thing. There we go.
This thing's shiny is also absolutely amazing. And I'm not gonna lie, I was kind of slightly tempted because of the increased shiny chances to maybe see if I could like reset to get a shiny one. But I feel like that would take forever and I have better things to do. So I'm not gonna do that. Alright, so that is kind of annoying how that Technoblast did so much damage. I think that's because he got the boost from download. Okay, I think he's just gonna knock me out right here. So it's gonna be interesting how we're going to actually KO this thing, or not KO, but get this thing to low health. I still need to get something with False Swipe. I'm gonna be honest, I'm kinda tempted to just use this Genesect for fun. Because I do love Genesect. But, I mean, it being a steel type, we kind of have to get rid of Steven, which I don't really want to. Alright, so we're gonna try and catch him in a different ball other than Master Ball. Although I do like Master Ball on him. don't really have any interesting balls. I guess I can throw some luxury balls. Maybe I can get lucky with that. Nope. Absolutely not. Honestly, I'm honestly tempted to just throw a Master Ball because I think it will suit him. And that's another reason why I was thinking of like maybe going to hunt for a shiny for him so I could just throw my Master Ball when I do do get a shiny. But either way, it still matches his colors really well, you know, the Master Ball as well. So I think I might just honestly throw a Master Ball. We could still like try and get a good nature for it. All right, we'll throw one more Luxury Ball and then see. It would be nice to have it in a Luxury Ball as well. Wait, 3? Wow, we actually caught it in a Luxury Ball. I guess we're not catching it in a Master Ball. We're saving the Master Ball for something else. Alright, that's pretty cool. Let's just hope its nature is pretty decent. You know, actually, I think I'm going to name him after Professor Turo from Scarlet and Violet because, you know, he was all about being futuristic and like, you know, he was an AI, and you know, it makes sense because Genesect is kind of like an AI. It's actually like a robot, so I think it actually makes sense for it. So we're gonna go with that, and hope it's a good nature for it. Okay, well, we can't check if it has a good nature yet. We would have to wait and see. I don't think I'm gonna reset for a nature. For a better nature, but we'll see. Anyways, we still have this boat to go to, which I think leads to a chorus battle, although we are kind of beat up right here. I'm hoping that maybe we can find a healing point in here, which would be weird in a Team Plasma base, I guess, but at the same time, there already was a healing point somewhere around here. I wonder if there's even anything over here. I mean, we can still hear the amazing theme in this. I mean, this team just goes so hard. No, the healing point isn't here anymore. Okay. Alright, what happens if we go over here? Hello, guys. The Plasma Frigate is a ship designed to be ecological. It runs on Kiram's ice energy and solar panels. You've got to keep the environment in mind when ruling blah blah blah. Oh, pure Kiram. It gets its device, cruelly forced it to work. It must have felt terrible. So, these are all... I wonder how we interact if we meet some... I guess these are all Reform Team Plasma members. Because I think, yeah, Chorus is right here, who's gonna probably want to battle me. But I need to heal first. I guess I can just manually heal up. I was hoping there would be like healing points, but... I don't think it's a wise idea to start with Superior, because he usually likes leading with like some kind of Steel type. So I think I'm actually going to lead with Clement. I feel like he might do really well. Alright, here we go. Could I say that you're curious for coming clear out here? I dissolved Team Plasma. The ones who are left here are deciding what they want to do. I would like to have them decide how to live on their own. There are far more questions in this world that don't have any answers. Well then, please show me your Pokemon strength once again. Alright, last battle against Chorus, here we go. Let's see, Pokemon Trainer Chorus. See what he has for us. He leads with Porygon Z. Okay. Should have led with Infernape. Alright. What do I want to do here? He's probably going to go for like a Tri-Attack or something. Or an Ice Beam probably. So I think I'm just actually going to go into Steven here. Oh, he's going for Trick Room. Okay. Well, can't say I was expecting that. But I outspeed him now, so that should be Porygon Z gone, unless he somehow survives. Oh, he has a Focus Sash. Okay, fair enough. Wait, and now he's going for Trick Room again? Alright. You're pretty weird, but I still have a Bullet Punch. Never mind, he has a Full Restore. I should have set up a Shift Gear, honestly, if I knew he was going to Full Restore. Let's see how much this does, though. Yeah, not enough. We have to Meteor Mash here. Gee, I could go for Shift Gear here, but I'm afraid that he will go for Trick Room again. No, he's going for Hyper Beam. Okay. I could have easily set up a... Wow, okay, that still does so much damage. Okay, wait, this is actually really good. that I missed, because now I can set up a ship here. And that should be the end of him. Alright, Meteor Mash, here we go. Because now I outspeed. Alright, perfect. Maybe Steven can sweep. I don't know the rest of his team. I think he has a Rotom Fan, which kind of walls me. Goes into his own Metagross. Okay. And he has an Air Balloon. Ooh, I do not have an Air Balloon. I might have to switch out here. Can't say I really was expecting the Air Balloon. Oh wait, I don't even have Earthquake. I forgot to actually put it back on. So I guess I'm just gonna go for Meteor Mash here. See what that does. Okay, not bad, not bad. Okay, yeah, he does have the Earthquake. Which is definitely gonna KO me. Which is fine, honestly. I don't mind. Because now I can set out Flint and just go for Fire Punch. Alright, here we go. Fire Punch. See you later, Metagross. Alright, two down. And I only have one down. So looking pretty decent. He's gonna send out Rotom. Okay, that was to be expected, I guess. I guess my only bet here is going to Brachius. That's just my best option here. Should completely wall this thing. And now I'm gonna set up with some Leaf Storms. That should be the Rotom gone. I mean, Rotom is pretty bulky, so he might take one. Nope, definitely not. Okay, cool. See you later, Rotom. And now I'm at plus two. I'm gonna send out Behem, alright. Can I KO you with a plus two Draco Meteor? Let's see. Will it be enough? Ooh, he barely lives. Okay, see, this is why... Oh, that's really annoying. Okay, well... See, this is why... why it's not that great to have the Wildlands is because you are losing out a little bit of damage. Because if I had like a Life Orb or like even Wise Glasses, I would have taken him out right there. But then again, I might have missed as well, so... I don't know. Can never really win, to be honest. Okay, I kind of want to save Brachius here. I think I'm going to go into Clement. I might actually outspeed him because of the Trick Room. And I want to stall out some Trick Room so that Brachius can maybe do some damage later. Alright, perfect. Did he have an Air Balloon? I actually... didn't see. No, he doesn't Air Balloon. Okay. Oh, I thought I saw something, but I wasn't sure. Okay. Gosh, I don't know what to do here. I guess I go to Flint and hope he doesn't go for anything crazy. He's probably gonna go for Flash Cannon. Yeah. Okay. Which I can take. Yeah, I eat that. And there goes the Twisted Dimensions. Alright, so now I can just close combat this thing. Hopefully he doesn't have Sturdy. Okay, no Sturdy. Good. Get Magnet Pull. Goodbye, Magnezone. Maybe Flint can just destroy the rest of his team. With that Rotom gone. Oh yeah, here comes the Kling Klang. Alright. Yeah, damn, he has like an Air Balloon and everything, man. He had three Pokemon of his had an Air Balloon. Alright. Well, goodbye, Kling Klang. Take that close combat and see you later. Alright, Flint cleaning up. I just did not expect him to have more than one Air Balloon on his team. So, I was like, wait, did I see that right? Did he have an Air Balloon? But I didn't want to believe it. But I guess he did. Pokemon battles where you can't afford to make a mistake. The true nature of the trainer's personality becomes clear. I see. If trainers believe in their Pokemon to the fullest extreme, as you do, their Pokemon partners will also give everything they have. So that must be the answer I've been looking for. Still, I'm glad you won. For one thing, I detested Getsus from the start. Take this with you. This Master Ball can catch any kind of Pokemon. Getsus was saving it, but you'll probably put it to better use. Oh, we get a second Master Ball. Okay, I guess I could have used the Master Ball on Genesect. Alright, we can actually rebattle him as much as we want, which is kind of cool. Alright, let's see if there's anything else interesting to this place. I don't think so. I mean, everyone has pretty much abandoned this place because of Team Plasma disbanding. Yeah, there's nothing here. We can't go through that exit. There's also this part, but I doubt this has really anything. Some people here. Goris told me that if I can bring out the power of Pokemon by taking good care of them, I can stay here. I mean, I was thinking maybe there's some kind of secret here now that, you know, Team Plasma's done for. Maybe there's like a secret person here that would give me something, but it doesn't seem like it. Oh, wait, hold on. Saying yes only so you won't hurt another person. That's not true kindness. Okay. Oh, we could have actually healed up here. Okay. I guess I will. Okay, and then there's this top area, which I think doesn't really have anything. This is just a part where does... we look down on the Kyurem. Alright, you know what I think I'm going to do? I am going back to the Giant Chasm, because I feel like Kyurem is going to be there now. So I kind of want to try and catch him. At least I think he's going to be there. We do have to give Fly back to our Brock here. But first, let's go and check out our Genesect right here that we got. See if it's any good. Alright, you're over here. Check out the Latios as well. It is a Rash Nature, which actually boosts special attack, so that's actually pretty good. It's actually holding a Soul Deal. Wait, we have three Soul Deals, because you're holding a Soul Deal, you have one, and then I actually picked one up on the ground as well. That's kind of crazy. You do not have... Oh, you have a Quiet Nature. That is actually kind of terrible. Means your speed is really bad. That's a little unfortunate. I mean, it does mean you have quite a bit of special attack, so that's good at least. Can Genesect learn False Swipe? I'm actually curious. If he can learn False Swipe, then I might actually replace him with Metagross. I don't think he can. No, he can't. Okay. I think I will keep Metagross then, because I think I'll just keep Metagross. Metagross is really good. When I'm looking through here, I don't think anyone can learn False Swipe on here. Unless maybe like Mewtwo somehow can. Maybe Drapion actually can learn False Swipe. Oh, okay. Roxy can actually learn False Swipe. Can he learn Thunder Wave? Because I don't think he can learn anything that puts things to sleep. But maybe he can learn Thunder Wave. I don't even know if I have Thunder Wave. Do I even have Thunder Wave? Ah, there it is. It's just in the Pokemon Center over here. Okay. Might as well buy all of these as well. Okay, Roxy cannot learn Thunder Wave, unfortunately. Which means I don't really have a way to status anything with it. So you would have to like switch out and stuff. Also, Roxy is way more lower level than the rest, so that's also kind of annoying. But I guess we can keep him for now. Maybe he will come in handy. I think I'm also gonna give him the EXP share, or her the EXP share, so that I might catch up in levels a little bit. Alright, now let's for real go for Fly to Lekkonoza Town and actually go after Kyurem. Alrighty, here we are, Route 13. We are making our way to the Giant Chasm. So my plan right now is to basically glare with Brashus like I've done before, and then just weaken him as much as possible, then let Brashus go down, just, you know. Just let him go down, so I have a free switch into Roxy, and then maybe like False Swipe him, just to get him a little bit lower. Alright, decided to use a Repel here, let's go down. Let's go back into the Giant Chasm. I'm assuming he's gonna be back here, but I'm not too sure. We're gonna have to find out. Okay, that's definitely not Kyurem. Okay. It's just Deoxys just literally just chilling here. I guess we'll catch it instead of the Kyurem. Yeah, I guess we'll still try the strategy that I was talking about. Here we go. Okay, so absolutely nothing. We just go into the battle. All right. Let's see here. I guess we'll go for the glare. He's gonna go straight for the Psycho Boost, which is probably gonna do a lot of damage to me. Yeah, that is definitely a lot of damage, but he's gonna let his special attack lowered. Okay, I'm probably Giga Drain him once, maybe. I'm gonna try. I think he might survive. Never mind. Let's try this again. I forgot that Deoxys has like no defenses. Alright, I guess we'll just glare you then right here. Okay, you're going for cosmic power now. You might actually be able to survive a hit then. Do I want to try? Not really. You know what? Let's just randomly throw a luxury ball. Nope. He just... Okay. I mean, what was I thinking? At full health? Alright, maybe with an Ultra Ball. Let's try an Ultra Ball. I mean, he's at least paralyzed. Nope. Okay, he's just gonna get paralyzed over and over again. Which means I'm just gonna throw balls. Because Gear Drain is going to do way too much damage. Okay, we got one shake. You're going for Hyper Beam. Alright, you know what? I think since you need to recharge, I think that is a good chance to switch in Roxy. Plus, you also can't hit me with your Psychic Boost. Alright, let's go for False Swipe. Maybe I can get a crit. Wow, that did absolutely nothing. Okay. What about Cross Poison? How much does that do? Alright, a little bit more damage. I'm too afraid to use it again though, because I might crit him. So I'm going to go for some False Swipes. Alright, he's getting paralyzed. This is good. The pressure is lowering my PP a lot. Okay, yeah, please keep getting paralyzed. This should get him to like 1 HP. Okay, not yet. This next one though. Man, he just is getting paralyzed a lot. It's my last False Swipe. This Deoxys is getting really unlucky. Alright, well, let's just go lob some more Ultra Balls. Here we go, Ultra Ball number one. One, two, three, wait. Ooh, I thought it was going to be like immediately the catch. That would be crazy. That would be, have been absolutely amazing. But let's throw another Ultra Ball and see. Ah, no shake that time. Alright. So we just got lucky, basically. Or, well, I guess we didn't really get lucky, but, you know, we got the three shakes. That's what I mean to say. Three? Oh, wow. Okay, that was really easy. Damn. I cannot believe that was that easy. Man, these were just really easy catch. The Genesect and the Deoxys. That's crazy. I didn't expect to find this here. Actually, I can't really think of a good name, so we're just gonna keep you as Deoxys. Alright. Well, we're done with that. Yeah. I don't know. So, honestly, we kind of did a lot of stuff in this episode. I kind of am tempted to, like, end of the episode here, because, I mean, we caught two legendaries, and we battled, Chorus. So, I kind of want to just end off the episode here. I mean, we got two mythicals, and then the next episode we can go after Kyurem and maybe even some other legendaries. I don't even know how to get to Kyurem anymore. There we go. Found it! Okay, I just want to see if he is over here before we make our decision for the next episode. No, he's not over here. Okay. Is he controlling Kyurem with it? Is Kyurem not up here? Do we need to do something else before being able to get to Kyurem? I don't know. Alright, well, I guess we're not doing Kyurem in the next episode then. I need to figure out how to get some of these other legendaries. I like running into them more, though, and like not knowing. You know. Be a nice surprise. Like this Deoxys, like this was a big surprise, and the Genesect. Well, I had a feeling the Genesect was there because, you know, that's usually like the place, you know, they are working on Genesect, but he was never actually there, but now he was there. But yeah. I do wonder how I get Kyurem, because I feel like that's one of the legendaries we should have gotten first, and we still haven't gotten that, so... either way, I think in the next episode, though, we might actually go to Twist Mountain, because we haven't done that yet. It's still an area that we haven't explored yet, and we might even come across some legendaries there. So, either way, for now, hopefully you guys have enjoyed, and in the next episode, we will do more stuff. So, thanks for watching.